We discussed about the ledgers. We discussed standard versus extension ledger. We discussed about what are the different type of extension ledgers. Okay, just give me a minute. I think this is not working. So let me try to watch again. Okay, and I think towards the end, we tried to create one document. We posted one document and we have seen how that document is available in the tables. So we understood that BKPF BSEC tables are still available, but there are some other tables like index tables and aggregate tables, which are now removed and they are replaced with views. So let's talk about this thing in detail. So if I go to this FB03 to see the document that we posted yesterday, either I can go to FB03 or maybe even if I go to transaction SE16M, and if I just try to go for AC doc A table. So this table is completely new table. This is called as universal journal table, or this is called as universal journal entry line items table. Okay, so if I provide my company code, which is SF01, and click on online, you can see it is showing us four records. So it is actually one document with two lines, but because we posted this in two different ledgers, system is showing the lines for leading ledger as well as non-leading ledger. Okay, so now let's try to understand the difference between standard ledger and extension ledger using this table approach. If I go to table Faggle Flexa, which was a table that we were using earlier. So if I go for that table, SE16N and Faggle Flexa, this was my old table, which is now converted as a view. Okay, earlier this was a table, now it is converted as a view. I'll tell you how you can see whether a table is a really a table or it is converted as view. So just provide your company code here, which is SF01, and if I again do online, now see what is happening in this case. In table Faggle Flexa, there are 30 lines, two line per ledger, but in AC doc A, we are only able to see two ledgers, 0L and IF. But when it comes to table Faggle Flexa, it is showing 15 ledgers. Okay, so if you go to table Faggle Flexa, we are able to see that the same document number has been posted to 15 different ledgers. Okay, so what is the difference? Why we are not able to see B2, E2, E3, J2, J3, J4, J5, why we are not able to see this in AC doc A? The reason is, in this company code, which is SF01, is actually assigned to how many ledgers? It is actually assigned to 15 ledgers. Okay, I'll show you how. This company code is assigned to 15 ledgers, and that is the reason two lines per ledger, so system is storing 30 lines. But out of these 15 ledgers, there are only two ledgers which are standard ledgers, which is 0L and IF. These are the only two ledgers which are standard ledgers. All other ledgers, remaining ledgers, that is 13 ledgers, B2, E2 and all, these are not the standard ledgers, these are extension ledgers. Okay, let's see whether we are correct or not. So if I want to see that, I'll go to new GUI window. If you go to SPRO, IMG, okay, we'll go to financial accounting, again financial accounting ledgers, and in ledger definition. So let's try to see all these ledgers, B1, not B1 actually, let's see which are those ledgers which are appearing here in Faggle Flexa. So we have B2, E2, E3. Okay, let's see B2, E2 and E3. You can see B2 is the extension ledger. You can see E2, E2 is also the extension ledger. E3 is also the extension ledger. So what is happening? only values which are in the standard layers are coming in table AC.A. The lines which are not relevant to the standard layers, the lines which are relevant to extension layer, those are only coming in Fagel Flexa table, which was the old table. Okay, the extension layer documents are no more getting stored in table AC.A. Okay, and let me tell you one more thing. This Fagel Flexa, although it shows you data, this Fagel Flexa actually is not consuming any memory in the database. Then the question is how this is showing the data. So see what is happening is, if I go back to, instead of SE16M, if I go to SE11 and write Fagel Flexa and click on display here, what you will find is, if you go to more, okay, and in utilities, there is something called as runtime object. Okay, so let's go to more. Within more, we will go to utilities, and within utilities, we will go to the runtime object and click on display. So what you can see here is, this is a table name, but this is actually calling some other table in the background. So physical table is not Fagel Flexa. Physical table is FGLV_Fagel Flexa. Now, what exactly does it mean? So if you copy this, okay, so if I just copy this FGLV Fagel Flexa and again go to SE11, FGLV_Fagel Flexa. If you click on display, now what you can see, again, this table is no more a table. See, this is now a view, not a table. Okay, and this is a view which is picking the documents from this tables, which is picking the records from this table. And actually speaking, again, this table is calling some other table in the background, which is FGLVGLSI. If I double click on this, again, try to do the same thing. Again, it is going to some other table. Again, if I double click on this, go to table join and condition, and ultimately data is coming from AC.A. Okay, so what I mean to say here is, whenever you do the transactions, let me put it in this way. So in SAP ECC, what was happening? If I have 15 ledgers, now obviously all these 15 ledgers were standard ledgers. Okay, there was no concept of extension ledgers in SAP ECC. So data will go to BKPF, data will also go to BSIC, okay, only for leading ledger. And for all the non-leading ledgers, data was going to Fagel Flexa. The lines were going to Fagel Flexa. Now in Fagel Flexa, all lines were saved in memory. Okay, so it was actually consuming the memory. So let's say, for example, again, this is just one simple example. Let's say 1 MB per record. So if I'm saving 30 records, it will consume 30 MB space in the database. Okay, so if I have thousands of records, it will be 30,000. If I have billions of records, it will be 30 billion. Okay, so unnecessarily, system was storing all the lines in the memory and it was consuming more memory. But now in SAP S/4HANA, okay, if I have 15 ledgers, now since I have the option of defining whether these ledgers are the standard ledgers or appendix ledgers. So let's say 2 are standard ledger in our case, and remaining 13 are extension ledgers. Okay, now in this case, data will still go to BKPF and BSIC. Okay, let me copy this. So BKPF and BSIC will still remain as same. BKPF will hold the header data, BSIC will hold the line level data for only the leading ledger. But Fagel Flexa, it is not 0 MB per record. It is not holding anything, so 0 MB. Okay, then where exactly the data is getting stored? If it is not stored in Fraggle Flexa, where exactly the data is stored? The data for other ledgers are stored in table ACDocA. Okay, and this ACDocA table will only consume memory for standard ledgers. Okay, what does this mean now? This means if I have data of 1 MB per record, and if I only have two standard ledgers, it will just consume how many? Only 4 MB of data. Okay. So if you just replace your ECC system with SAP S/4HANA system, this data, this 30 MB space will be saved, and you will be only needing 4 MB of space in the database. While from the reporting point of view, if you still want to run the same report what you were getting from Fraggle Flexa, then what will happen whenever you ask any information from Fraggle Flexa, it will redirect to some FGLV. It can be anything. I'm just giving this example, FGLV, some different views, and ultimately it will also bring the data from AC.A. Okay, so this Fraggle Flexa is no more going to store any data in the database, but from the reporting point of view, through the CDS view concept, it will bring the data from any other table. Okay, so in this case, it will bring the data from AC.A. Okay, so that is the basic difference between the normal standard ledger and extension ledger. Now the question is, if in AC.A table, if in AC.A table I don't have any information related to the extension ledgers, where exactly this information is coming in terms of Fraggle Flexa? In Fraggle Flexa, how the system is showing that there is data? It is showing because if you see here, whenever you create an extension ledger, you need an underlying ledger. Okay, what do you mean by underlying ledger? This means whatever documents will be posted in leading ledger 0L, these postings will also be available for reportings in all the appendix ledgers or all the extension ledgers for which the base ledger is 0L. Okay, if you're not able to understand, don't worry, I'll give you one example. Let me tell you once again. What I mean here is, let me take this scenario. Okay, or let's create one more document and see how it works. Okay, so I will go to transaction FB50. What is this? FB50. Something wrong. Local currencies for company code SF01 cannot be completely determined. Why? Because we already created this yesterday. We were able to post a document also. Let's see. If I go to leading ledger 0L, company code settings for SF01. Currency code is not defined for currency type 30. Oh, somebody has deleted this. Currency code is not defined for currency type 30, company code SF01. If you remember yesterday, we created a entry here for currency company SF01 and currency S30. So somebody has deleted it, due to which we were getting that error. Okay, so let's go with this INR. Source document type is document currency, exchange rate type is M, and then transaction date is translation date. Okay, just click on save. It is saying an entry already exists, then why are we getting error? Let's go back. PRO. Go to the ledger settings. Now we are not getting that here. Now it is still there. Currency code is not defined for currency type 30. Company code SF01. This is creating some problem. I think somebody has played with the configuration that we created yesterday. Let's try one more time. Currency codes. Let's see if I try to save this, if I'm still getting that error. Let's try MCFP50. No, something wrong. Local currency for company code cannot be completely determined. This is the reason, this is a problem in the test servers. Somebody deletes your configuration, then you are gone. Whatever configurations we have done, those are gone.
Can we check the currency settings?
Yes, but currency code is not defined for currency type.
I think currency code, the hard currency and all these currency, I think somebody has.
Which one? This one you are seeing?
Yes.
It's already there.
Okay.
I think
yes.
Not okay. This is the problem with all the group currencies. Group currency is gone. Any idea where exactly the group currency is maintained? It is maintained in SCC1.
Yes.
Yes, that is the problem. So let's go to SCC4. Which is our client, I think. Yeah, somebody has deleted this current. So let's click on it. Fine. Okay, now I think it should work. So let's go to FB50. Yes, it is working now. Okay, so if I specify the document date, 17/09/2019. GL account I used to, 4000 would be debit, because 400, sorry, this would be debit, which is our expense account, and 2000 would be, or 200 would be credited, because this is my bank account. Okay, so let's say amount is 500. Here also it is 500. System will ask us for some mandatory information. So it is just giving us the option that document date is in the future. It should be okay. Or maybe we can change this, enter. So now CO assignment. So which means we need to provide the cost center. So SF01/1, this is something which we created yesterday. Now it is asking for value date. So value date is 17/01/2019. Okay, and click on post. Okay, so what we are doing is we created one document. Now let's try to see this document. So I'll go to more document and display. So this document is posted. But if you see here, this document is posted without the ledger group, which means this document is posted for all the ledgers which are assigned to this company code. Okay, and if you want to see for which ledger this document is posted, you can go to this general ledger view. There are two views, right? If you are using new GL accounting, this is the entry view. Currently we are in the entry view screen. If you are using general ledger accounting, new GL accounting, then only this general ledger view will become available. If you click on general ledger view, you can see here it is showing you the ledger. Okay, so it is telling you this document is posted to ledger 0L in this way. But if you want to see the document in other ledgers, you can go to other ledger button. Okay, and you can see this document is actually posted to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 ledgers. Okay, and if you want to see the document in B2, E2, wherever you go, it will show you the same thing. Okay, same document is posted. But if you see this ledger B2, in the bracket, it is showing you this was posted in 0L, but since 0L is a base ledger for, let me show you this one in configuration. Close the configuration. So let's go to SPRO, financial accounting. Okay, so for B2, you can see underlying ledger is 0L, which means whatever you will be posting to 0L, it will also go to B2. Okay, and that is the reason system is showing that in B2, this is also posted as same as in 0L, but this is not actually going to be stored in table AC.A. In AC.A, only 0L will be stored, and all the other ledgers which have been defined as extension ledgers under this underlying ledger, those will also be available for reports. Okay, if you want to deactivate a particular extension ledger, let's say for example, now there are 15 ledgers which are assigned to this company code, and if you don't want to use all these ledgers, you only want maybe one or two ledgers that are extension ledgers, you can easily deactivate all other ledgers for this particular company code. Okay, how to do that? You can again go to the configuration. If you just come out of this, I'll say no. If you go to this deactivate a ledger for a company code, here you can specify which ledger you want to deactivate and just specify the date or year on which you want to deactivate it. So if you specify 2018, from 2019 onwards, this ledger will be deactivated.
From the starting of the year, correct? Or in the mid of year, we can do that?
No, from the start of the year. In mid of the year, you should not do this. Whatever ledgers, these are all very critical settings. You should not do this in mid of the year.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. So let me, I think still it is, I don't know whether you understood or not, but let me again make it simple to help you in understanding the concept of appendix ledger, how it works. Okay, so in our case, there are 15 ledgers. That is the reason you may not be able to understand correctly. Let's take this example on the notepad with only 3 ledgers. So let's say we have a requirement of India GAAP, we have a requirement for IFRS, and we have a requirement for US GAAP. So in this case, we will create 3 ledgers. Let's say India GAAP, we are already using 0L. For IFRS, we will create a ledger IF. And for US GAAP, let's say we will create another ledger, which is US. Okay, so this 0L would be my leading ledger. That means this will be standard ledger. This IFRS, this is my non-leading standard ledger. And US GAAP is non-leading extension ledger. Okay, now whenever I'm doing FB50, whenever I post any accounting document, it can be coming from AR, it can come from AP, it can come from asset accounting. In short, whenever I'm posting any transaction in accounting, if I'm not specifying that for which ledger I'm doing this transaction, it will go to all ledgers, right? Whatever transactions I'm doing, if I'm not specifying that this is related to US, this is related to IFRS, this is related to India GAAP, that transaction will go to each and every accounting principle. Okay, now can you tell me why, again, I'm going to the basics. I think we already discussed this topic, but still, in order to understand this completely, let's again talk about that topic. Why do we need different accounting principles?
Reporting purpose?
Sorry, for?
For reporting purpose?
Yeah, for reporting purpose, but what kind of reporting process? Like what do we have different in different accounting principles? Okay, let's take this example. You are trying to do the accounting entry, okay? And in this one, let's say you want to book the expenses, okay? And you want to debit the bank. Sorry, you want to debit the expenses and credit the bank account. Now, in this case, when you try to do this transaction, whatever transaction, if I'm asking a simple question, whenever you want to post any accounting document, you go to normally transaction FB50. Are you worried where exactly this transaction will go, where exactly these postings will go? Normally, most of the postings that you do on day-to-day basis, let's say you are booking the invoice, you are making the payment, you are doing it at the header level. You are not specifying for which ledger you are doing. This is actually going to each and every ledger, right? So when you use this transaction FB50, this posting will go to 0L. So let's say what will happen to my tables. Okay, so first there will be two lines, one for expense, second for bank. This would be for leading ledger, which is 0L, and for bank also it will go to, there will be one line for 0L. Again, this will be also replicated for other ledgers. Okay, so if I have ledger IFRS, this will also go to IF, this will also go to IF. Okay, let's say I'm talking about ECC. So this example which I'm giving you is for ECC, and in ECC normally this Fagel Flexa table was doing this. So what is happening, if you are trying to post two lines in a document and there are three different ledgers, so 2 into 3, total 6 lines are getting posted in SAP ECC. Okay, but what was happening because of the 6 lines, unnecessarily, if I have same information available in 0L, same information available in IF, same information available in US, then why unnecessarily I am creating the 6 lines? I can actually create only 2 lines for 0L. Others will automatically pick the data from 0L because there is no difference. Right? If there is no difference between 0L, no difference between IF, no difference between US, then why unnecessarily we are consuming more memory? That is the reason SAP thought, why should we again and again say the same information multiple times in the table? So they said, now in SAP S/4HANA, they came up with the concept of extension ledger, which means if you are creating the standard ledger, system will still store the lines separately. But if you are storing the data in the appendix ledger, if you are creating the extension ledger, in case of extension ledger, you will definitely get the reports on US. If you want to see the report only on US, you can just see the information what is available in 0L if this is your underlying ledger. Okay, so in short, US reports will be still available, but not, and the table will not be able to see anything related to US if the postings are coming from leading ledger. So ultimately, you are trying to save the memory in the database. That is the whole idea here. Appendix ledger will not store any new lines in the table, or extension ledger, sorry. So it is one and the same thing. Whenever I'm talking about appendix and extension, this is one and the same thing. Only based on different versions, they change this terminologies. Do you have any question here? Okay, let's go to the next one. Let's talk about this index and totals tables now. So if you remember, I told you there are two types of tables which are no more available in SAP S/4HANA: index tables and totals tables. What is the difference between index table and total table? If I give the example of index tables, all these tables, BSIS, BSAS, BSIK, BSAK, BSID and BSAD. These are all the examples of index tables. Okay, whatever information is available in BSIS, BSAS, BSIK and all, this information is already available in BSIG. Then too, we created separate tables. Why? Because BSIG table, if you try to do the reporting from the BSIG table, there are a lot of columns available in BSIG, around 200, 300 columns in that table. Okay, and earlier in SAP ECC, the data was stored in the row-based form. Which means if you try to get the report from the table where there are many number of columns, the report will become slow. Okay, why it will become slow? Because it will take the time based on how many columns are there in the report. But now in SAP S/4HANA, we discussed that they came up with column-based database. In the column-based database, irrespective of how many columns you have in a table, report will still take the same time. And that is the reason there is no need of any index tables in SAP S/4HANA. Okay, so all these tables are gone. Second type of tables which are gone are Fagel FlexT, which are called as total table. Fagel FlexT is for mutual accounting, and for classic GL accounting, there was a table GLT0. Okay, again, these two tables are gone because in SAP ECC, our calculation engine was not very strong. If you remember on day one, I gave you the example. If you want to summarize what is the total balance of a particular GL account, you have to perform this calculation. But in SAP ECC, calculation engine was not that much strong. And that is the reason these calculations were done at the time of doing the transactions. Now in SAP S/4HANA, the calculations can be done directly at the time of reporting. And that is the reason there is no need of total tables anymore. Okay, so how to check whether these tables are really available or not? So to check whether this are the tables or these are the views, you can actually go to transaction SE11, as I shown you earlier. Just go to transaction SE11, specify your table name. Let's say my table name is Fagel Flex T. Okay, just click on display. Okay, and here you can see in the bracket, it is clearly written that this is a view. This is no more a table. Okay, even here also you can see this is a display view, not a table. What do you mean by view? View means Fagel FlexT will not store any data anymore. Okay, Fagel FlexT is not going to store any data anymore. The data is actually getting stored in ACDoc A table. Okay, I'll show you how. So if you go to view, if you just click on table join conditions, again, you can see the data is actually coming from other tables. Again, if I double click on this table, this is a backup table. Just forget about this. Let's go to this other table, go to table conditions. Again, go to table conditions. Again, finally, you will find the data is coming from ACDoc A. So ACDoc A is the only table which is supplying the data to the views. Okay, views means they are not storing any data. They are just created for the reporting purpose. I'll tell you why. Now let's say, let's make it more interesting. If I ask you the simple question, you are using SAP ECC today. Your customer is using SAP ECC today. And in SAP ECC, there were tables like BKPF, BSIG, Fagel Flexa, BSIS, BSAS. And this customer is using SAP from last 10 years. And they have already, have lot of Z reports which are created. Okay, and let's say there is one Z report which is trying to get the data from Fagel FlexT or let's say table BSIS. Now, if you are saying that SAP has removed that table, Fagel FlexT and BSIS and all, what will happen in that case? In that case, if the user will try to run a report, that report will not work. Do you think in that case, customers will go for SAP S/4HANA? They will say whatever money we invested to developed those reports in the past, all those reports will not work in SAP S/4HANA. Then what is the point? We have to start everything from scratch. Okay, and customers will never accept that solution. That is the reason SAP said, okay, no need to worry. You are, even though if the tables are removed, but your reports will still work. How they will work? So we are removing the tables, but we are providing the views. What will happen in the views? In the views, your data, although it is not stored physically in the table, but automatically system will go and pick from the main table. Okay, so even though there is no data in Faggle FlexT, but system will not say, no, I don't have any data. It will automatically in the background, it will go to table AC.A and it will pick the data for you and at much faster speed. Are you able to understand this? Akash, Mahesh, have you understood the concept of view? If you're not understood, please let me know. I'll try to give you more examples in that case.
Please repeat again, sir.
Which one, Akash?
This view, I can't understand.
View concept, okay. Yes. Okay, let me tell you one more time. So, see, earlier, let's try to make it very simple. I'm removing all these things. So let's say there is a customer. Okay, you are customer in the sense, I'm talking about the client. You are working with the client and they are using, client is using SAP from last 10 years. Okay, and there are around 200 reports which are picking the data. So picking the data from table Faggle FlexT. Now in SAP S/4HANA, Faggle FlexT table has been deleted. Okay, so if a customer is trying to execute any of these 200 reports, system will give dump. System will give dump because this table is no more available. Okay, and due to this reason, do you think the customers will implement SAP S/4HANA? They will say, no. We will continue with SAP ECC only. Am I right? If you tell the customer that all the amount, all the effort, all the time that you invested all these years, that is not going to work because you have to again rewrite your code, you have to rewrite your Z programs to pick the data from the new tables, will customer accept this situation? Will he accept this solution? What do you think? Yes or no?
No.
He will not accept, right? He will say, provide me some solution in which even though you are trying to delete this table, but my reports should work as it is, right? My earlier reports which are developed from here, they should not get impacted. Right? So the solution from SAP is, solution to this problem which we just described is, if we delete the tables, create them as views. I'll tell you what is views now. Okay, so whenever a user is running a report which is trying to get the data from Faggle FlexT, although there is no data in Faggle FlexT, what system will do? System will automatically in background bring that data from AC.A. Okay, as a user, let's say if I'm a user and I'm trying to get some report, even I will not know what is happening in the background. In the background, SAP has written a code that if anybody is asking you the data in Faggle Flex Key, don't say customer, no, I don't have this data. Don't be the dumb. Just go to table AC.K and find the information and give it to the customer. So as a customer, I will not get impacted because my reports, old reports, even if tables are not available, my old reports are working as it is. This is only available because of the views. If the views are also not available, then everything will be done. The customer will be angry. He will say, I'm not able to generate my old reports, and what is the point in implementing SAP S/4HANA? Right? Maybe not the technical. If I give you the simple, another example, which is very easy to understand. Let's say I gave you some information. Okay, I gave some information to Akash. Let's say I given some documents to Akash. Okay, and now Akash has deleted all that information from his mind. He is no more aware about that data, what I gave to him. Okay, and after a few days, if I go to Akash and ask him, please provide me this information, and if he says, no, I don't have this information, then definitely I'll be a problem because I'm not getting my information. But let's say before deleting that data, Akash has given that data to, let's say, Prashant. Okay, so now if I'm going to Akash, please give me this data. Akash is not saying, no, I don't have this data. Akash is saying, okay, just wait, because I gave this data to Prashant, let me pick the data from there and give it to you. So in short, as a user, I am not getting impacted because I'm still getting my data. When I'm asking Faggle Flex Key, it is not saying, no, I don't have any data. Faggle Flex Key is going to AC.K. It is picking the data and it is giving to me. Okay. So although it is a lengthy process, although in the background, this is a lengthy process, but because of the capability of SAP HANA, you are saving a lot of space in the database. And obviously because of that, even though the process is long, but the time which it takes, it lesser compared to how much time it was taking earlier to get the data directly from the table. Okay, so views are created to make sure that there is no impact to your previous reports. They will work as it is because even if there is no data available in those views, views are capable to bring the data from the main table. Does it make sense now? Now you understood what is a view? Yes, Prashant.
Yeah.
Yeah. Akash, have you got your answer?
Yes.
Okay, so that is the purpose of view, and that is the reason there are a lot of tables in SAP ECC which are now in SAP S/4HANA, they are converted to views. Okay, so you can just, if you want to know whether a table is still a table or a view, you just do one thing, go to SE11. Okay, again, I'm showing you once again. Just go to SE11 transaction, specify the table which you want to check, click on display. If this is display view, this means this table is not a table, this is a view. Okay, so for example, if I go and do the same thing for AC.A, and if I click on display, see, this is not a view, this is actual table. So table is something who will store the data. View is something which is not storing any data, it is just bringing the data from other table. Okay, that is the difference between CDS views and tables. Okay, so now what I was saying is, if you are creating, yes, any question, Prashant? There is some background noise from your side.
No.
Okay, can you just mute yourself?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's go further and do the remaining configuration. So if I go to SPRO once again, so although we completed the basic configuration, we are able to create the documents also. But let me show you some new configurations which are available for the first time. So if you go to SPRO, there is this conversion of accounting to SAP S/4HANA. Now this is called as a conversion cockpit, which is mainly used when you are trying to upgrade or when you are trying to convert your existing SAP ECC system to SAP S/4HANA system. So this will only show you the data things which were not available earlier and which are brought for the first time. Okay, so we are going to talk about this convergent cockpit in detail when we'll be discussing the convergent scenario. Currently, we are discussing the new implementation scenario. Okay, and that is the reason we don't need to discuss this one. Let's close this. Let's go to financial accounting once again. And within financial accounting, if you go to general ledger accounting, and then if you go to periodic processing, integration, okay, and here okay, may not be here, just give me a minute. Business transactions, where is that controlling integration? Just give me a minute. I think it is in financial accounting. Ledgers, yeah, integration of controlling with financial accounting. So this particular thing, even you will find in SAP ECC also. If you go to financial accounting, ledgers, and integration of controlling with financial accounting. But if you go here, you will never find these options what are available currently. Okay, just give me a minute. Let me see. Let me quickly try to get the ECC server, because it would be very easy if I show you the difference between the two rather than just showing you what is new in SAP S/4HANA. Just give me a few minutes. Maybe you can take a 5 minutes break. I will configure the ECC system and then I will show you the difference. Let's take a break for 5 minutes. We'll again meet at 8:30.
Okay.
Okay, are you back?
Yeah, go.
Okay. Okay, so this is now ECC server. So if I take you to SPRO, okay, IMG. And if you go to financial accounting, see, if you remember, I already discussed about financial accounting and financial accounting new earlier. So in ECC, we were able to see financial accounting and financial accounting new. This one was available if you activated new GL accounting, and this was available if you want to use classic GL accounting. Okay, so now if I go to financial accounting new, within this financial accounting global settings, ledgers, and this real-time integration of controlling with financial accounting. Now, if you just try to concentrate on this particular screen vis-a-vis this particular screen, which is integration of controlling with financial accounting, and this is real-time integration of controlling with financial accounting. So if you open this, you can see define variants, assign variants, define rules, define field transfer. Everything is common. Okay, so if you see this, define document types, define document type mapping variants, define and default normal default values, define ledger for CO version, and define account determination. So whatever was available here, those all things are common. Only account determination is remaining. Account determination for real-time integration, but 1, 2, 3, 4 activities are replaced with another set of 4 activities, okay, which are completely new. The reason is, in new GL accounting, SAP came up with the concept of integration of CO to FI, real-time integration, which means, again, FI and CO were two different components. So whatever you were posting to CO, it was flowing to FI. Now, since FI and CO are both the same components, there is no question of sending the data. It is only the new configuration where you need to specify these things. Okay, so if you remember, yesterday we already done this particular configuration. Define the ledger for CO version. Okay, where I told you in SAP ECC, only leading ledger was sending the data to controlling. Okay, but in SAP S/4HANA, you can specify which CO version will get the data from which ledger from FI. Okay, so that configuration we already done, but there are three more configurations which we need to do. First one is define the document types for posting and controlling. I think this one also we discussed yesterday. I told you yesterday that there is a new document type for CO postings, which is nothing but document type CO, and if you double click on this, only this GL account and secondary cost is allowed. You cannot post asset, customer, vendor, material manually. Okay, this question come on the certification exam also, that can be which are the account types allowed in document type CO. So you have to make sure that no manual postings, sorry, only manual postings are allowed. Sub ledger postings are not allowed in document type CO. Okay, so this was about the document type, where you can create your new document type for CO related postings. And then this is a place where you will be specifying, there is something called as document type mapping variant. Okay, what is document type mapping variant? So if you open this and go to this particular screen, here you specify, you know, there are a lot of different types of business transactions that you do in controlling. So whenever you are making any secondary postings, whenever you want to make any secondary postings into controlling, these are the different business transactions, right? Primary cost posting, secondary cost posting, internal order settlement, actual settlement, there are a lot of things, right? So you are telling the system that whenever I'll be performing any of this CO transaction in SAP S/4HANA, which document type should be defaulted? So obviously, as of now, there is only one document type for all the different type of CO postings. And that is the reason for all the transactions, system SAP has given only document type CO. But if you want to create your own document type, you can create your own document type, and then you have to assign your document type to different business transactions. Okay, but it is recommended not to touch this standard delivered document type mapping variant. If you want to change something here, better to copy it, create a Z, okay, and then you make whatever changes you want. And in the last step, you have to assign this document type mapping variant to your company code. Okay, so in this place, you will be specifying which document type variant will be used in which company code. Okay, and if it is time dependent, let's say from today you want to use this one, but from start of the next year you want to use something else, so you can specify the validity from. Okay, and what do you mean by default ledger group? Default ledger group again is the same thing. Whenever you will be making any postings into controlling, whether the postings will go only to the leading ledger or they will also go to all the other ledgers. If you keep it blank, the postings will go to all the other ledgers, which is completely fine. There is no problem in that. But if you want to restrict, which means whenever I'll make a CO posting, it should not go to any other ledger. You can specify the default ledger group here. Okay, so that is something which can be done in this configuration. By default, this is blank, which means whenever you do any CO postings, it will flow to FI in all the ledgers. Okay, so let's come out of this now. So these are the configurations which are now related to integration of controlling with financial accounting, which is completely changed when you compare it with your ECC integration of controlling with FI. One or two more things which I need to show, which are part of general ledger accounting. So if I go to conversion of accounting to SAP S/4HANA, although we are going to talk about each and every step here, but as of now, I just want to show you one thing. So preparation for general ledger account. Yeah, now it's working. So preparation and migration of customizing for general ledger. In this one, let me tell you one very important thing. Define offsetting account determination type. Okay, what is the offsetting account? Any idea what is the offsetting account? Have you come across this situation or scenario where customer is asking you that if in my FBL 3N report, let's say I'm running FBL 3N report for GL account 2000 or 200, sorry, for GL account 200, and if I click on maybe all items execute. So here system is showing me the main GL account. Let me just try to change the layout and bring the account number here. Okay, so account type and account, let's bring this account here. So I'm getting this account, in which account this posting was done. But if I want to know which was the other account, which was offsetting account. So when I credited GL account 200, which GL account was debited? In our case, it was 400, right? So any of your customer have asked about this requirement that they want to see in FBL 3N report, they want to see the offsetting account also? Anyone who came across this situation? Okay, normally this is common. Customers are not happy with the standard SAP report of FBL 3N. They say that we are able to see that this GL account was debited or credited, but if you want to see which was a corresponding GL account. Okay, so if, let's say for example, if this is my bank account, so I want to know which expense account was debited. Did we make the payment of 200? This was against which expense, which type of expense? So that particular thing is called as offsetting account, and customers ask for that. In SAP ECC, also it was possible to determine, although in the standard FBL 3N report, you will not be able to find the offsetting account field in SAP ECC, but if you want it, it was possible to achieve that. So that is the reason I'm just trying to understand from you, anybody worked on this offsetting account or not, and how it was possible. Akash, have you come across the situation, Prashant? No. Okay. It was possible through BTE. You must be aware about BTE. Have you seen BTE, business transaction event, FIBF transaction? Anybody worked on that transaction? FIBF. Okay. That is actually the technical transaction that normally is referred by your technical consultants. But using that transaction, FIBF transaction, it is possible to activate that functionality of offsetting account. But it was still not considered as standard, and that is the reason customers were required to, or maybe the technical team was required to make an extra effort. But now this offsetting account is very much available in your standard delivered content itself. So if you just write offsetting, okay, you can see offsetting account type and offsetting account. So if I go for offsetting account, you can see here itself it is showing you that when this GL account was debited or credited, which GL account was used as the offsetting account. But the problem is, in this case, your offsetting account is exactly one. Okay, let's take an example. I am doing the transaction. So GL account posting, where my 200, which is nothing but my bank account, is debited. Okay, so it is, credited. So credited by minus 500. But my expense account is not one. So this is my 400 is my rent expense, which is only 100. 401 is my travel expense, okay, which is again 300. And last one, 402, is, let's say, my insurance expense, which is another 100. So in that case, can you tell me what will be the offsetting account for 200? If I'm looking at the report for 200, which will be my offsetting account? 400, 401, or 402? There is one account which is getting credited, but there are three accounts which are getting debited. So which should be my offsetting account? Just a guess.
Bank account.
Sorry, Akash, you are not able to hear it clearly. Can you come again?
Bank account with offsetting account.
Rent account. Why rent account? Why not travel? Why not insurance? Just try to make it interactive. Why not travel? Why not insurance?
I think all three of will be the offsetting account.
Not possible. You cannot have three accounts available here, because in the GL line item display, for one document line item, it will only show you one line. Okay, so here you can either have 400, 401, 402. You cannot have three different lines here. Okay, it will only show you one GL account. Okay, so the question is, this customer has to answer what he want to see in this case. Whether he want to see, normally customers will go for this one. Customers will say, we want to see the GL account with the maximum value. Okay, so that configuration you have to specify here. So what exactly you want to see, you have to determine here. So first one is, do not display the offsetting account. So there is no point in displaying that offsetting account. You are saying the system that not required. Don't display any offsetting account, keep it blank. Second is display the offsetting account if clearly specified. What does this mean? Display the offsetting account if clearly specified. So if there is only one offsetting account, show it. If there are multiple offsetting accounts, forget it, keep it blank. Number two is always display the offsetting account with the highest amount. Okay, which we are discussing currently. This is a standard setting by SAP where they say always display the account with the highest amount. And fourth one is always display the offsetting account highest amount all lines. Okay, highest amount all lines means this one is highest amount in a particular line. What is the highest amount? But this is if you are let's say this one is related to the FI posting. If you have a FI posting and there are multiple amounts, you will be picking the highest amount. But let's say if the postings are coming from other modules also, let's say you are trying to do the good receipt, you are trying to do the Miro, you are trying to create a billing document. So there are other GL accounts also which are available in those documents. So even those lines also will be considered when system will try to find out the highest amount. So highest amount of the line items. Maybe if you want to see this explanation, you can just do F1 and see if something is available. It is not showing you anything. So why I'm doing this is because you should have a habit. What will happen is whenever you are seeing any new screen, just try to do F1. So maybe the documentation, what SAP does is in first two releases, they don't provide the documentation, but then later on when the functionality becomes old, the documentation is very clear. So that is the reason I have a habit of looking at the documentation, whether it is available or not. Okay, so in short, these are the four options. Based on what you want to see, you can select in this particular configuration.